The Scarcity Attraction Pattern. My friend told me this interesting story about something that happened to him the other day. He goes to this one library because a couple of the librarians are really, really pretty. And he has built up a pretty good rapport with both of them. They have interesting conversations whenever he checks out the books he checks out, just so they can be conversation starters. The last time he went in, one of the ladies was in a really, really good mood. He asked her why, and she said she was in love. Like, head over heels, can't stop thinking about it, love. So he asked her if she might be able to objectively describe some of his behaviors that made her fall so deeply in love with this person. She said that she suspected that it was because he seemed so confident. Unlike most guys who start off strong but always lose their attraction over time. This guy started out average, but her feelings for him have only grown over time. When they talk, it's only to set up the next date. He never chit-chats very long on the phone. His texts are short and sporadic. She said every time they do talk, he ends the conversation way before she does. This makes her think about him. Similarly, when he texts haphazardly, and the texts are almost like half thoughts, half cryptic messages that aren't ever completed. She said it absolutely drives her crazy. So crazy that every time her phone vibrates, her heart rate nearly doubles because she hopes it's him. Every time they have a date, they haven't slept together yet. She can't sleep the night before. But then she said he might be running some kind of advanced psychological game. She asked her what she meant by that, and he just stood there watching calmly, not wanting to interrupt this flow of valuable information. She said that she watched a guest lecture at school from a Harvard psychologist who's been studying the dynamics of romantic and sexual attraction for a few decades, and they've actually reverse-engineered some of the most powerful forces of attraction generation. They are so powerful and so repeatable that they've taken average-looking guys with average-looking personalities and have taught them these strategies. And they taught them how to use these conversational attraction-building strategies in both online dating and events like speed dating. And they worked so well they had to stop the experiment. The ladies were falling in love so much they were worried they were going to get sued. She said it was kind of like the Stanford prison experiment. It worked so horrifyingly well they had to stop the experiment before it was even halfway over. They had to stop these attraction experiments before they were over, since they were able to create real feelings of love in so many women. Deep feelings of love so desperate they were worried some poor woman would be emotionally damaged for life. It all has to do with scarcity and the different ways to leverage scarcity. There is scarcity of information, there is scarcity of time, and there is scarcity of deep connections and laughter. One level of scarcity is the frequency of the texts. Another level of scarcity is the frequency and length of phone calls. Another level of scarcity is the emotional openness shown during dates, both with eye contact and physical touching. Another level of scarcity is frequency of laughter and the frequencies of stories shared. She said it only takes a day or two to learn this, but it's pretty easy to teach. And once they took these random guys and taught them the right frequencies of the right kind of scarcity to demonstrate, the amount of love they were able to generate was mind-boggling. But then she said, "I don't care if he's running game on me or not, because I feel so wonderful now to be in love with this guy. I'm willing to do anything to please him, anything to make him happy, including anything I possibly can sexually to catch him and to keep him." My friend asked in as offhand a manner as he could for the Harvard psychologist who ran that study, but she said she specifically didn't document any of her findings. She said she was too worried people might misuse this powerful love-generating, sexual desire-building, scarcity, frequency, bliss, mind programming technique. But she said she would take notes and tell both her and him what she found and what worked the best, so you could reproduce this in any girl you want.